Hi guys, in this part of the video we will discuss about the classification of phylum Arthropoda. So let's we talk about the classification of phylum Arthropoda. First of all, we study about the phylum Arthropoda's general characters, general features of this, phylum Arthropoda. The word Arthropoda, coined by Bon Seaborg in 1845, and the meaning of the word is a jointed appendage. This means that animals of this Arthropoda phylum contain segmented appendages or jointed legs. That's why the name is Arthropoda. Artho means jointed and poda means legs. In the Greek word, are segmented and poda's leg. That's why the name is Arthropoda. According to map, in 1953, it had 8,63,000 of its species, so it is the biggest phylum of the animal kingdom. Now I will talk about the characters of the phylum Arthropoda. As we have already know that artho means joint and poda means foot, that means that these animals have the jointed foot. The general characters of the phylum Arthropoda: their body have triploblastic. It means that they have the three types of germ layer. That's why triploblastic. They have bilateral symmetry, segmented body, and the body can be divided into three parts. That is head, thorax, and abdomen. Segments group into two or three regions, and these three regions are called tagmosis. Renewal chitinous exoskeletons are found in this phylum Arthropoda animals, because the exoskeleton is made of special type of carbohydrate that is called chitin. So the growth of these animals by the molting is a process by which they remove their exoskeleton by the molting process. They have open blood vascular system, body cavity filled with blood hemocell, tubular alimentary canal is found, and with mouth and anus. They contain dorsal heart with ostia, dorsal brain with ventral nerve cord. Their respirations occurs by gills, trachea, lung books, or sometimes cutaneous type of respiration. Striated muscles are found in these animals. They does not have cilia. Paired segmented appendages are found. Sexual dimorphism are found in these animals. It means that we can easily recognize male or female, and metamorphosis, special character metamorphosis, found in these type of animals. Now let's we talk about the classification of phylum Arthropoda. It can be divided into seven classes, and these seven classes are: the first is Onychophora. It means Onychophora, the claw bearing animals. It contain characteristics of both phylum, which are the both phylum Arthropoda and Annelida. So the Onychophora class contain both the characters of phylum Arthropoda or Annelida. That's why it is called the connecting link between both phylum. For example, Peripatus, and this Peripatus is a living fossils. Now the second one is Crustacea. Crusta means shell, so the animals possess shell. The animals are aquatic, terrestrial, or boat type. Body divided into two parts, and these parts are cephalothorax and abdomen. Respiration by surface of the body or gills. Excretion by green gland, because the Malpighian tubules are absent in this animal. So the excretion occur by the green gland, for example prawn, crab, bullhouse, etc. The next is Arachnida, and Arachns means spider. Arachns, the meaning of the Arachn is spider. So mostly spiders are found in Arachnida class. Body divide into two parts, cephalothorax and abdomen. The special character of this class Arachnida is four pairs of leg, because the insects have three pairs of leg and these Arachnida have four pairs of legs. So we can differentiate easily Arachnida to insects. Antennae, the most character, the antennae replaced by the chelicerae, because antennae are not found in Arachnida, that's why the chelicerae are found. Respiration occurs by the lung box, and except ticks and mites, all animals of this class are carnivorous. For example, a scorpion, spider, ticks and mites. The next is chelopoda, and chelo means lip and poda means appendage. This means that the animals have lip-like appendages, for example centipedes and scolopondra. Next one is the diplopoda. Diplo means two, or poda means appendages, for example millipede and zulus are the examples of this diplopoda, because they, the animals of diplopoda have two legs in each segments. Trilobita, this is an extinct group. And next one is the hexapoda or insecta. These insects are the hexapoda or insects. We will discuss later about the insects in detail. Now let's we talk about the position of insects in animal kingdom. In this picture you can see the classification of the insects. Because the kingdom of these insects are Animalia, and the phylum is Arthropoda, subphylum Uniramia, and class is Insecta. So this is the position of insects in the animal kingdom. In this picture you can see easily. In the next picture you can see the Arthropoda can be divided into seven classes, and these are the seven classes: Onychophora, Crustacea, Arachnida, Chelopoda, Diplopoda, Trilobita, and Hexapoda. We have discussed already about these all seven classes. And here is a, you can see here Onychophora, these are claw bearing, and the example of this Onychophora is Peripatus. Crustacea means animals bearing cells, and the example of these crustacea is prawn, crab, woodlouse. Next one is the Arachnida. Arachnida means mostly spiders are found, and the example of this Arachnida, scorpion, spider, ticks and mites. Next one is the chelopoda. Lip-like appendages are found in this class, and the example of this chelopoda is centipede. Diplopoda, and two legs per segments are found in this diplopoda class. So the example of this diplopoda is millipede. Next one is a trilobita. This is an extinct group. Next and last one is the hexapoda. Hexa and hexapoda means legs. So the animals of this class have three pairs of legs or six legs. And the example of this is insects. We can see insects. In insects, sorry, in insects, in means internal, in means internal, and sex means cut, that's why it's insect. Internal cuts are found in insect. Next one is now in this table I will see the relationship of insects with the arthropod. There are some characters by which we can see the, we can observe the characters and different types of this class. The first character is habit. Habit of Onychophora, Arachnida, Chelopoda and Diplopoda terrestrial, because these are these four types of classes: Onychophora, Arachnida, Chelopoda, and Diplopoda. These are terrestrial, but the crustaceans are aquatic and few terrestrial, and insects many terrestrial and very few aquatic. If we will talk about the body regions, the Onychophora body region is not distinct, but the crustacea two body regions is found: cephalothorax and abdomen. Arachnida three body regions are found: pro, meso, and meta. So for example, scorpion two pro and opisthosoma, for example spider. Chelopoda, in the Chelopoda the body region is two body regions can be divided into two parts: head and multi-segmented trunk. In Diplopoda can be divided to head and multi-segmented trunk, but the insects three body parts are found: head, thorax, and abdomen. Head, thorax, and abdomen. Now we will talk about the antennae. Onychophora, one pair of antennae. Crustacea, two pairs. Arachnida, no antenna. It's a most character that no antennas are found in Arachnida. But Chelopoda, one pair. Diplopoda, one pair. And insects, also one pair. Only the crustacea have two pairs of antennae and antenna. This is the most beautiful character of this crustacea. Two antennae, and all others have the one pair of antennae. But Arachnida class does not have an antenna, and this antenna replaced by the chelicerae. We have already talked about this. The antenna replaced by the antennae. Antenna replaced by the chelicerae. Okay. Now the next character is visual organs. Visual organ not distinct in Onychophora, but in Crustacea one pair stalked and compound eyes are found. Arachnida one pair simple eyes. Chelopoda one pair simple eyes. Diplopoda also one pair simple eyes. But in insects are both simple eye and compound eyes are found. It's the most beautiful character of this insects phylum, insects class. Both simple eyes and compound eyes, both are found. Then under the next characters, we will talk about the locomotor organ. In locomotor organ, Onychophora class, many pairs of unjointed legs. Many pairs of unjointed legs. See, minimum 5 pairs of paramus legs. Arachnida, 4 pairs. Only 4 pairs. This is the best, most character, 4 pairs. We have already discussed about this. Now the next is Chelopoda, one pair per segment. First pair of leg modified as poison claw. Yeah, keep in mind, first pair of legs modified as poison claw. It's the special character of Chelopoda. Now the Diplopoda, two pairs per segment. In Chelopoda, one pair per segment, but in Diplopoda, as the name is suggest, Diplopoda, Diplo means two, or Poda means legs, so one segment contain two pairs of legs. So two pair per segment, no poison claw is found in Diplopoda, but the Chelopoda poison claw found. And here insects are three pairs of legs on three thoracic segment and two pairs of wings on meso and metathorax. These are the special feature of these all classes. Now the next character, mouth parts. In Onychophora, non-mandibulate. These animals are non-mandibulate. It means that they do not have mandible. And the crustacea, mandibles found, one pair of mandibulate. These are mandibulate, one pair. Arachnida, non-mandibulate, but possesses chelicerae. Yeah. The Chelopoda, mandibulate, one pair. Mandibulate, these also one pair, mandibulate. Insects also mandibulate. only carotenoids are non-mandibulate and onychophora non-mandibulate. All other classes contain mandibule. Now the next character is respiration. The respiration in onychophora class cutaneous, crustacea gill breathing, in arachnida book lungs, in chelopoda tracheal, diplopoda also tracheal, and insects also by the tracheal system. So in chelopoda, diplopoda insects are insects animal. The chelopoda, diplopoda and insects animal respirations by tracheal system, and in crustacea gill breathing, and the onychophora cutaneous type of respirations. And a special character of arachnida, book lungs are found like a scorpion, and tracheal in spider. Both type of respirations are found, tracheal and book lungs. Book lungs only in scorpion. Now the next character is body fluid. Body fluid, all the classes have hemolymph. So this is the same for all. Now circulatory system in onychophora, heart with ostia, and each and every class have the heart with ostia. So this is also same for all classes. Now the development of onychophora anamorphosis. Crustacea also anamorphosis, but the arachnida metamorphosis absent is in a scorpion, and metamorphosis is present in mites. Both type of development is found by metamorphosis or non-metamorphosis. In a scorpion metamorphosis is absent, but in mites metamorphosis is present. All other classes like chelopoda, diplopoda and insects have metamorphosis. It means that development by metamorphosis. Okay, now the next character is habit. So onychophora animals feed on organic matter. Crustaceans, herbivorous and carnivorous, arachnid phytophagous and predators, chelopoda carnivorous, diplopoda herbivorous, and insects phytophagous, predator and parasitoids.